get over here and I want to introduce this gentleman, the son of Wes Montgomery. Let's give it up for Mr. Robert Montgomery. He's going to say a few words.
Hey, my dad in here? Look, first, it's always an honor to stand in his place. Not in his shoes, but in his place. And to know that he's so phenomenal. And you know, you don't always have words, but I do have some words. And for a moment, I'm going to step out of his place into my own place. So when I do that, you know, I'll pay attention to me. But I was thinking now, we are celebrating not just Wes's birthday, but 100 years of Wes, 100 years. And he's still prevalent, and he's still at all of what he's doing, what he's done, and what he'll continue to do. So I wrote this out. This is, I want you to know my readers. To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to give and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to keep silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. So in everything, there is a season. And I believe this is Wes's season and time. Some it's long over, some say it's long overdue. That could be true. That could be a true saying. But if this is his season, then all things had to line up for this time and this season. The father of faith, Abraham, was promised that he would have children who numbered the stars. And that time, he had not his own. Though he did not live to see the promise, it was fulfilled. And I believe the promise for Wes is that he would not see the promise, but he would bring joy, peace, love, compassion. That he would break the racial boundaries. That he would be the greatest jazz guitarist in the world. He would literally change the world with the sound of his heart and character, though he did not see it. And yet the promise is still fulfilled. For he who promises faith, if he said it, won't he do it? And will he not bring it to pass? Wes Montgomery, 100 years, and we're still in awe, and we are still counting. Thank you for loving my dad for what you do. And God bless you all.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen, Robert Montgomery. Is everyone ready for the show? I know I've been out here. Let's give a great round of applause for Indianapolis Jazz Collective featuring Mimi Mimi Box.
Influence is written for a bass player of mine back in the the San Francisco Bay Area, and this is called Mr. White's Blues. Thank you.
addition to celebrating Wes, I'm celebrating my new CD, which is a tribute to Wes. And Ozzy and I, thank you. And as a homage to Wes, it may surprise you to know the title of the CD, One for Wes. Anyway, this is another piece from the recording, and this is my arrangement of the great Bobby Timmons piece, Moanin'.
Thank you.
I talk about this all the time. Sometimes you don't know what you're getting, and which has been good for my solo guitar playing because I've had to work on that. Because sometimes, you know, depending on where you are, you get what you get. And in this case, I got what I got. And I decided to call him Nick Van Winkle. I just stick to playing the guitar and stuff. And how about a hand for Steve Ali? So this is another one from my new CD, another one where I'm sure you will hear the Wes influence. This is a tune I wrote for a friend of mine called Blues for Wes. Along with Blues for Wes, Blues for Less. Which means I can get it for you wholesale.
Thank you. Thank you.
So this is another original of mine written for another great guitar inspiration. And this is one I wrote for Django Reinhardt, the great gypsy guitarist. And I actually, an interesting factoid, if you're ever on Jeopardy and they ask a question about my ancestry, I found out recently that I actually have some gypsy blood, which is cool, going back a few centuries probably. A few years, let's put it that way. Anyway, so I come by it honestly, and to prove what a sap I am, this song is called For Django Abeckamore. Thank you.
Thank you. for the Indianapolis Jazz Foundation. First and foremost, I just want to say what an honor and pleasure it is to work with Mimi Fox, and thank her for coming all the way out from California to be a part of this celebration. And one of the main people that actually, the person that actually made this happen and suggested Mimi was Mr. Robert Montgomery. So I want to thank Mr. Robert. And I just want to say it's been fun going around with you all this week. You know, it's interesting to see. Robert has to go to a lot of city council meetings and mayor events, events with a lot of politicians that are making proclamations to West Montgomery about how his significance and what he. But it's actually fun to be there because I can see as they read off West's accomplishments that they didn't realize how big this guy is, how impressive his resume is. Is there whereas this and whereas they won a Grammy, whereas saying in records, and they're like, oh wow. You can almost hear their voice like, you did all that? What? It cracks me up. But it's been great, you know, because it's been a great education for a lot of people in the city about like how we have this shining star in Indianapolis. It's from Indianapolis, you know, that influenced the world, not only just in guitar, but music. So thank you, Robert, for traveling around with that. You know, it's been amazing. I want to acknowledge a couple of people because this show is brought to you by the Indianapolis Jazz Foundation, and couldn't do all the things that we're doing and pay these musicians wonderful checks if it wasn't for the foundation. So I want to acknowledge Mr. Mark Sisko, who's the board president, and the Hoboks is here, and we have Mark Sheldon and Lynn Fraunhoff. So give them a round of applause. And then I did want to acknowledge a couple other people. Helen Small is here. She's from the former CEO Woo! Of NPA. And Helen's amazing. You remember when they had Jazz Fest and it was like huge. It was brought to you by Kroger. Helen would make it rain money here in Indianapolis. So. And then we got a whole bit of the raining and drizzle. So, but we're trying to make it rain again. So, also, Mr. Lamar Campbell is in the house. A great musician. So let's give him a round of applause. World famous Lamar Campbell. And Julia is at the table and she has a birthday. So happy birthday again. I wanted to let you know how you can support the foundation. We have t-shirts that you can take home. This obviously is not my size, but.
No, but you know what's good? They have small. Usually I go to festivals all the time. They give me everything is men's sizes, and so I get these t-shirts, and they're like pajamas, right? And so, but they actually have a small that I got, and they have small, medium, all the way up to extra large, and they're really nice t-shirts.
They're awesome t-shirts, right? So before you leave tonight, take home one with you, you know, and along with one of Mimi's CDs, because she's got a lot of CDs. She's a limited supply of CDs, right?
I just have what I can stuff in my suitcase.
Okay, there it is.
So yeah, come see me afterwards. I'm happy to sign it, and I'm very excited. I just finally got Square. I entered this century. So if you come back to
we can't do it without the Jazz Kitchen. David Ali, yeah. Mr. Frank Sears, yeah. And the house, Mike Alfred, Teresa, all those staff are amazing.
Okay, wow. Once again, this is going to be our last number for this set, and I want to just thank these wonderful musicians with me. Greg Archie. Steve Ali.
Kingston.
So, also, I just want to say something about my friend, my new friend, and my precious friend, Robert Montgomery. I might start crying. Oops. Robert, I can't tell you how much it means to me to have you as a friend, and for all of everything that you are and your humanity. You are a beautiful human being, and I'm so lucky and so fortunate to count you as a new friend. So thank you, and thank you for everything that you do. And just now I've got to stop. One of the great geniuses of the 20th century, as much recognition as he does deserve. But see, in my alternate universe, the street signs in Indianapolis all say Montgomery Way. Everywhere. I can think of a few street signs I'd like to change. So, anyway. Robert, because you talk the truth, speak the truth all the time, this student, here's another original of mine, which it's a long story, and I'll talk to you about it later, but it's called Pack of Lies, and since Robert testifies all the time to the truth, I'm dedicating this to you, Robert, because you are the antidote to this, too, so Pack of Lies. Thank you.